So welcome everyone to the session, Getting Started with Xcode UI Tests by none other than Shobhan Babu. So we are glad they could join us today. And without further delay, over to you, Shobhan.
Thank you, Shweta. So let me share my screen quickly. Hello, everyone. Hope everyone doing good and hope everyone is fine during this pandemic. We are starting with getting started with XUI test. So in this session, right, so I am going to cover how you can automate things with XUI test, and we'll discuss more how XUI test responds and the test, how you can write everything. So before starting my session, I would like to introduce myself. So this is Shobhan Babu. I am a consultant at ThoughtWorks. So I have a 6+ years of experience in manual and automation. And these are, so I'm basically very passionate about automating new tools and technologies and learn from it. And this is my GitHub IDs and LinkedIn and Twitter. So you can follow up me. And if there is any questions after this session, you can reach out to me this using this tag. So without further delay, we'll get into the agenda of today. So a little bit, we speak about what XUI test and what are the downsides of XUI test. And we are going to write a first test. And we sometime talk about what is APIs in XUI test and what is the weighting strategies and gestures, how you can automate with gestures and parallels, how you can parallelize your test execution and CI integration with your XUI test. And finally, we'll be having some time to ask question and answers. Cool, hope you're clear with agenda. Okay, people, so what is XUI test, right? So XUI test is a native framework which helps us to automate your native applications. Support from the iOS application and iOS platforms. And XUI test is written, the test is written using Objective-C and Swift. So it's a part of the Xcode. So you don't need to download the XUI test explicitly download it in Joker. So whenever we install the latest version of Xcode, it will automatically download your XUI test bundle. So this is what the XUI test. Then I'm going to touch upon the Swift, the language. So it's a native language which helps to write an automation test for XUI. And it will support seamlessly with your existing Cocoa framework. So Cocoa framework is nothing but it's existing the native framework. So we can support with the Swift language. And it's very modern and fast, and it's very type safe. And it's very easy to learn when compared to the other languages. The Swift developers, right? So they took ideology from the other languages like Python, Ruby, Perl, C Sharp. So that is much different to learn about Swift. So this is pretty much about the Swift. So we'll jump into why XUI test, why we need it. So already some of you got an idea. So XUI test helps us to automate the native applications, and also it's a native framework, and it's a very easy to set up things, and you easily the maintain. Why so? Why it is easy to maintain? Because the XUI test, it sit upon your development code. So it will emphasize your code pairing with the dev. So you can easily approach developers, and you can write a test, and you can get immediate feedback from it. So this is why XUI test helps more on our execution flow. And the most thing is the accessibility. So we don't need to spend extra effort on testing the accessibility. So why I'm saying is XUI test morely depends on your accessibility modifier. So here we don't see any IDs or XPath, so those things. So it's more depend on your accessibility modifiers. So I can apparently say when you do with the accessibility modifiers, you can avoid most of the flakiness on your test, because you are going with your accessibility modifiers. So two in a one way. So this is what the XUI test, and So definitely we'll be having some cons about each framework, right? So here in XUI test, there are some cons. People already got to know it's only support for native frameworks, and the cross-platform, which will not allow with using XUI test. And you can use only the native languages, the Objective-C and Swift. So other than then, these are the cons from the XUI test. Okay, we quickly jump into, so many of the people has in mind, right, what XE test and XUI test, because when I started, I have the doubts in my mind. So from the image, you can actually, you can directly get the context. So XE test is mainly for white box testing. And, so it purely on unit testing, and you can do integration and network monitoring and performance, everything you can do it with XE test. But XUI test is purely on black box testing, which we are doing, right, interacting with UI components and the accessibility testing, everything you can cover with XUI test package. And the difference between XE test and XUI test, right, because both are fit into your dev code, the only difference is XE test supports HTTP protocols. In Appium, we will be doing the external HTTP calls using Axios NodePage Lite. So likewise, so the XUI test will not support the HTTP protocols. So that's a only difference between XE test and XUI test. Okay, so now how my test look like? So this is my first test case. So here I have attached the sample test case, how it look like. So we have used Swift as a language, and I have imported XE test because XUI test come from XE test package, and I have created my first test case, and this is extends from the XE test case class. And here I am initializing my application as an app variable XUI application so that I can use across all the methods and pages. And there are three functions here I am derived. So one is setup and test example and teardown. So inside the setup, you all know, right? We need to initialize the application and launch, and the basic setup before you launch, everything will be carried out in the setup method. And the test example, whatever we do actions, right? Tab or the assertions, interaction between new elements, everything will fit into test examples. So in the set setup, I have I have defined my setup as a super so that I can get all the context to and share to the other pages and other functions so that you can interact with multiple pages. And the second, I am setting up the flag. You can also set up the flag here, continue after failure, false. So it means if there is any failure during my execution, it will not stop immediately. It will execute the next test case, and it will provide you the feedback. And the app.launch, it's straightforward. It will launch your application. And here, as I talk about, we don't need to use any of the IDs, XPath, and everything. So everything will depend on your accessibility modifiers. So here, app is the application which I launched. The static text it's a class which helps us to take the element for view schedule link. So I'm taking the element for view schedule link, and I'm using tap method. I'm clicking the element. So this is how you can do interaction between application with your application. And using XCT assert class, I am asserting whether the U1 alert box exists or not. And you can handle the alerts also using app.alerts. This is the part of, it can be a native alerts, also it can be your application alerts. So both the ways you can handle using the alerts. We'll see how it goes further. Okay, without further delay, I would like to take you the demo. So how it look like in the Xcode, right? So this is a Xcode IDE, and here I have a first test case, what I explained in the slides. So how you create a test case first? I already said, right? So we are setting up our XUI test inside the development code. So we need first the code base, which have the successful build and which can deploy the application into your simulators. And likewise, I have the application here, which is developed for the gaming application. So it will have a managed members, So this is the sample application. So if you see my emulator, so I'm opening my application. Yeah, so this is a simple application. So it has a more info. It will direct to you the web view and manage team. You can manage your teams like size. There is a slide bar and pickers. So this is a simple application to manage your gaming purpose. And this is a code setup for that. And there is a second package called products, which has your the .app and .ipa will fit into this package when you build your application. And this is a UI test, which I already created. The first thing what you need to do is, so you have to go to file and you need to create a target for your application. So it means you are creating your XUI test bundle. So just a minute, it's opening. So here, this is a way you need to create a target. Okay, yeah, it's open, sorry for the delay. And here you need to select the iOS because I'm going to write XUI test for iOS application. Here you need to search for UI bundle. This is the testing bundle, which carries your all the packages, XUI test packages here. And if you click on next, you will see the product name, which you need to mention. And if you click on finish, you can see the packages created for you. So this will be having one plist, which has default configuration, and this will be having one .sift file. Okay. And you have some curious, right? How you can run your test with your Xcode IDE. So there, here there is a option providing the play button. So you can simply run the functions or test using this icon. So let me quickly run the application now. So when you started running, so it will terminate, already open the application. Yes, so the testing is started. So I can see the launching UI test here. So you can see the UI test runner is the installed for each XUI test run. So the UI test runner, it helps us to interact with your application. For example, in Appium, when you run the Appium test, it will install WebDriver agent in your the emulators, right? So likewise, the XUI test will install the test runner first, and then the test runner will interact with your application. So my test runner is installed now. So now it will deploy the application, which is Wally here. So now my tests are launching Wally. This is the application name. So meanwhile, I'll go through the chat if there is anything. Can the load and look into. Yes, I have a code in GitHub, so I'll be sharing after the session. So it's launched my app, and it will click the view schedule option here. So actually, finish game and click awesome. Yeah, so now my test is finished. So once the test is finished, you will be getting the pop-up here, and then the test green will be passed. And that report, right, when you have multiple tests, you will be having the confusion what test is passed and failed, right? So if you click right side, there will be a jump to option. They are providing the native reports with XUI test, and you can see the very basic level of reporting here. And in the session, I'm not covering out the report configuration, everything. So here are the basic report that you can debug your tests actually. Good. Hope you understand how we can write a test and how it is interacting with your XUI application. Right? So yeah. So let's talk about what is XUI test APIs. When I say APIs, right? So APIs is very important to interact with components and whatever actions you do that communicate with the APIs, right? In XUI test, we have three APIs that is major major contribution of your XUI application. iOS application. So XUI application is an first API which helps us to launch the application and tear down the application. And if you want to launch with the arguments or the environment variable, so that you can do with the XUI application. And then XUI elements, which takes the control of the current snapshot, and it helps us to click the element or whatever action you want to do with the components that will take care of your XUI element API. And XUI element query, this API helps us to take a snapshot of your page of elements, and it will help us to query, assert, and finding the element. So everything will be covered as part of this XUI element query API. So quickly we go through, we'll compare our first test with our execution flow, how it works with the APIs, right? XUI application, first it will call XUI application API and it will launch the app. And then it will call the XUI element query, and then it will find the elements, which we find out view, there is a game tab, right? So that element will be finded using XUI element query. And XUI element API will actually talk to the element or tap the element on the screen. And then we have asserted the element using XUI element query. And then we need to tear down, right? That will take care of XUI application API. So this is how the execution flow will be carried out through your entire test cases. Okay, let's see the demo, how it works with your application, right? So for having a demo, I am having enabled the debug mode and I'm running my test again, the same test, okay? So you can see my UI test runner is installed and my testing is progressed. Okay, yeah, so you can also see the console logs here. So once my application is deployed in my simulator, so my debug area will be open. Okay, you can see it's starting automation session. Actually, it will creating a session ID here in this step. And if you can see, it will attach our test cases with our application. Actually, my system is something slow, so that yeah. So my now application is open, and also you can see my debug area is also open here. So now what I'm going to do is I am going to interact my application using the APIs which we discussed about. First, I am just calling a print object method, which helps us to print the console logs when you interact with APIs. I need to get the application, right? XUI application dot. Okay, let's again. Okay, so when I do this, it will actually interact with your page and it will get all the page source which is available as a current snapshot. Like we do in Selenium, right? If you want to display the get whole page source, you can display the page source here. And also we'll have some curiosity, right? How we can find the elements using this API, right? So for that, what we can do is, for example, if you want to get the elements for buttons, right? Let's say if I do buttons, so actually buttons come from XUI element query, which find the elements on your page. Okay, so when I click on enter, you can see it will interact with your snapshot and it will provide the buttons which is available in the screen. So here I have only one button, which is more info. So I'm copying that element here. And what I do is I'm just going to interact with the element. So there are tab. There are most methods that's available as an action. So if you want to tap, you can tap your element, and it will be going to the web view. So that is a expected functionality here. So it's already clicked the more info button. So it will move quickly to the web view. It's like a ripple. For example, if you take an example of Tyco, whatever actions we do in the console, we can see immediate feedback from the web page or application, right? So likewise, the XUI test APIs also communicate with your iOS applications, and it will provide and it will give the feedback to you. So this is how you can interact with your APIs. And also, if you want to launch the application, right? So you can launch the application, launching with arguments and launching with environment. So there are many launching options is available. With using these classes, you can do with the launching methods. So for example, if you want to if you want to change the context between apps, right, you can use bundle identifier, and also you can switch your apps. For example, there is a default app is available in iOS, right? Apple News. So I'm going to open Apple News using the bundle identifier. So when I click that, you can see here, it will open your Apple News using the bundle identifier. So this is how you can interact your application with the API. So once you, before you writing the test case, you can interact with that, and you can probably get the feedback, and you can write your test cases. It's pretty cool, right? So one more thing, how you will be updating I already said, right, this is an accessibility modifier. How would you identify, and how you can modify, right? So here, whenever you have a dev course, right? So there are options in your application, and each application will be having a storyboard, okay? When you click the storyboard, it will open the navigation of the screens. So once that is open, you can actually click on the element which you want to update the accessibility modifiers. So let it open. Yeah. So this is a storyboard, right? So main.storyboard. It will having the views for each screen. Let's say if you are in a home screen, you will be getting the home screen components in the storyboard, and you can select that, and you can modify your accessibility elements. Okay, we'll quickly go to the next topic, and then we'll come back until it loads. Okay, my next is the weighting strategy, right? When I talk about the weighting strategy, so the XUI test having some, the default weighting strategy is provided. So here I have listed down some of the weighting strategies here. The first one is the wait for the existence. So it will explicitly wait for the element to be appear or it exists. Based on the timeout. And the next one, the expectation. So you can set the expectations, and then you can get the, whether or true or false, you can get that, and you can wait for the expectations. So this is the second thing. Here I have provided one example expectation. Here I'm using NS predicate. So predicate is nothing but is a querying language in Swift, which helps us to query the exact match of your elements. I don't want to dig more into the what is predicates and everything. So that helps us to match the elements based on our query. So here I'm setting up my query like exists equal to true. Okay, so I'm setting up against my identifier as buttons. Okay, my button which has identifier accessibility, it will wait for 5 seconds, and then it will satisfy the conditions. If not, it will actually throw the exceptions. So this is how you can set the expectation and wait for expectations. And the last one is thread.sleep. Actually, the thread.sleep, it's not a recommender in any of the languages. So I have striked out, but the option is available in Xcode, XUI test as well. And there are many other waiting strategies like until, wait for until, but those things are having a different framework like Cookpad. So that's a framework available for XUI test. So if you are going with that framework, you can use the many until wait and wait for the, you know, wait for the fluent. So everything, those kind of waits you can handle in the different frameworks. Okay, so initially we talked about the storyboard, right? So this is a storyboard. So this is a home page. You can find the elements using the storyboard. And here I'm giving an example of more info. When I click more info, so here there will be a class path available. Okay. Okay, it's loading again. Okay, so it's loaded. You can see the custom class in the navigation bars in Xcode. So here you will be having some accessibility, the section. Here you can enable the accessibility. So you are enabling the accessibility and providing the label as more info. Then, you can directly interact with your accessibility modifier. So here we are, majorly decreasing your dev communications here. So whenever you want something, you want accessibility modifiers, you can, quickly go to the application code and you can change your accessibility monitors. So if you are, for example, if you are using Appium for your, applications, iOS application and native applications, you can directly come here and you can change and you can get the accessibility modifiers in an Appium test as well. So this is how it helps to update the accessibility modifiers. Okay, cool. Next, I am jumping into gestures. So how gestures will look like in native applications and how you will be automating it. The first thing is tap. So here the tap is called for click. It will be clicking when you call this tap method. And the double tap, it will double tap the element based on the element you are querying. And two finger tap, when you want to tap with two fingers, you can call this method. And one major thing is you can tap with number of taps and number of touches. So that you can configure within a one tap. So you can just to provide the elements and the arguments in a number format, and you can do the taps in between your application. And the press is for long press. If you provide the duration, it will press until the duration is completed. And the scrolls, right? Those scrolls you can do simply calling the swipe left method. It will be swipe left of the element and swipe right and swipe up and swipe down. So these are the scroll methods. And pinch, so this is a special option here, the pinch. If you want to zoom in, if you give a velocity of a pinch, and just it will zoom in and zoom out of your the page or whatever the image which you provide the element. And the adjust, right? So these methods the same method will be interacting with your slide bars. I will show you how the slide bar will look like here. And the picker wheel. So picker wheel is a native component in the applications, right? iOS application. So you can automate the picker wheel by selecting the value here by calling the adjust method. Okay, so let's quickly I will jump to my test case. I have some gestures here. So this is my, I have provided all the gestures methods test here. For example, I have a manage roster here. So in the manage roster, I want to scroll down so that, okay. Now it's not happening. Okay, fine. We'll move to the next one. Okay. So it's just a picker. For example, it's a manage team. You will be finding the pickers right here. So I want to select the values from the pickers. Okay. Okay, so for that, what I did is, so I just tapping manage team button from the home page, and I'm giving the values of my picker values. I'm providing him the selected format variables, and I'm asserting whether it is exist or not before I select the values. And I'm using here the predicate, which I need to exactly match with the element, so which is attacker's information. There are two things here. One is attacker's information, and other one is the setter's information. So attackers and setters. So I'm just querying with the attackers and using the picker wheel class, and using this, the picker wheels, I actually identify the picker wheels which is present in the application, and it will pick the value which exactly matching with 5 attackers, and it will select the value here. The same way, the same same set of function for the setters. So let me execute. You will understand more. I'm just running this test by clicking the application here, and my build is succeeded. Okay. And my UI tester runner are installed, and its testing is processed. So meanwhile, I will go through the chat.
Yeah, so thanks. Shobhan, yeah, Shobhan, we can take one question if it's going to take time.
Sure.
So we have one question. Image shows Android and iOS. I think it was from one of the previous slides. So is XUI, so does XUI support Android as well?
No. So this XUI test package is for only supporting the iOS platforms. So there is a different package available for Appium. So that also you can do it with XUI test. Actually, Appium, which has a XUI, like we have a UI automator, right? So those we can use that, and you can also use the Appium for testing. But in this session, we'll be covering only on XUI test package, which will help us to automate iOS application. And next question, how we can cover accessibility testing using XUI testing in terms of voice over, color, contrast, and touch target and UI objects. Actually, I'm not sure about the voice over and color contrast. Actually, we'll take this question as in a hangout session.
You want to take the next one, which is about the BDD framework?
Yes, XUI supports the internal BDD framework in it, but it actually not refers to the BDD style. Like you will be having given when then, so it will automatically have the BDD flow in it. So you can install the plugin BDD plugin in XUI test, and you can do the BDD as well using the XUI test. And
we have one from Monil Joshi.
Yes. Do we have a complete application project, app build, opened Xcode, or we can simply automate any application by downloading? No, you have. So actually, we are not providing any application path or IPA for a path to the XUI application. It will automatically deter from the code base. So actually, your code base should be present in your XUI test. So what is the process of XUI test over Selenium Appium test? So basically, XUI test preferable when you have only the iOS application. So it will be very fast when you compare with other, other frameworks. So because it has a native component, so it will directly interact with your application, and it will provide the quick feedback. So here my local system have some issues in CPU thing. So you can have some delays. Yeah. So what is buttons, more info? So actually the more info is an accessibility modifier that I showed before. Using that accessibility modifier, you can actually interact with your elements. Yes. More info is an accessibility element. So in a page, if view elements are there, the page source of identifying is easy. but if the there are more than 50 plus elements, it's a bit difficult. Yeah, so actually so that's why we are calling the methods, right? So if you want to print buttons, only it will print the buttons. If you want to print only static text, it will print only the static text elements, or else you can use the storyboard to find the elements as well. Okay, so parallelly my test is running. You can see my screen. So it will click the view schedule now. Sorry, manage team now. Okay. Okay, we'll go through the next question. Meanwhile, how we can cover accessibility testing using XUI? We'll be taking a separate things. Okay, it's opened the manage team and it selected 5 attackers and 1 setters. So this is how you can automate the gestures using a methods called the gestures. Tap or a swipe and everything, you can do it. So the next one, the question raised, how we can do a parallel testing with XUI test, right? So we don't need extra effort spending on your parallel testing. Actually, XUI supports parallel testing in a native way. And so this is a scheme which I forgot to tell you. You can create an n number of scheme for the single application. You can create the scheme for UI test, and you can create a scheme for XUI test, and you can create a scheme for performance. Likewise, you can create n number of streams, and you can point out here. If you want to edit scheme, you can click the scheme, and it will open the dialog box, and there you can select which test you want to run, and which test whether it needs to be run parallel. So here UI test. So this is my test which is displaying here. If you don't want to run this test, you're just clicking the uncheck the box, it won't run. So this is how you can edit your scheme for parallels, right? If you click options here, there will be an option execute in parallel. So that is a disclaimer if possible. So there are many constraints. So in your Mac, if you have a very capacity of Mac, then it will clone your multiple, for example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 clones, and it will run accordingly. So you can see execute in parallel. So this volleyball one scheme and UI test will execute in parallel mode. So I just try to execute now. I'm not sure. Let's say I will execute this. This is a very simple test case, right? When I execute, you can see in simulator I have only one devices. So once it is started, you can see the cloning devices here. So my testing is progressed. Okay, so yeah, we will So we'll move on to the next topic. So we'll see once it is opened. And the next one is CI integration. So how we can integrate my CI, CI with XUI tests. So here I'm using Travis CI as my integration tool, because we can integrate with any of the CI integration tools. Here for the demonstration, I choose Travis CI. And there is a between XUI test and Travis CI, that is a fast lane which helps us you to build the Xcode built-in command line. So when you want to run the XUI code in terminal, you have to pass many parameters and many things. So for example, if we want to device settings and the output directory, the report, everything, you need to configure manually when you do Xcode build. But Fastlane, it will automatically detect your configuration from the from your XUI test, and it will run in a simple command. So this is the Travis YAML file, which has my Travis CI configurations. And here I am specifying the language Swift because I'm using Swift here. And I'm providing the OSX image as OSX image, which should have Xcode version as 12.5.1. And the branches which I'm running on the main. And before install, I need Fastlane. Every time I need to install because the Travis VI opened the MacBook instance at each time and on new image. And in the script, I'm mentioning the scheme name. So first it will scan the dependencies. So it's not there, it will install. And the scheme name should be default. So actually here I change the scheme name as Wally. The scheme name, whatever the you want to run against your exhibitors, you can mention your scheme here. And the devices, which the device name you want here. And so this is a Travis CI bash, dashboard. So here I already ran in the morning. So you can see the results here. So once the commit is happening in the GitHub, it will automatically trigger my build for my XUI test. First, it will install the Fastlane and it will install all the dependencies before installing the Fastlane. And after that, it will trigger my command, which has which again to run the default scheme and the device called iPhone 11 Pro. And once it is done, it will, I already mentioned, right, it will automatically get the arguments which it's needed. So it will automatically set the values as well. That's what we are using the Fastlane here. And the once we are building, it will deploy the application into your simulator and it will start the test. So these are the tests has been ran in your Travis CI application, integration CI. And you can see the results of 12 test cases run and 0 failure. It's very simple and straightforward integration, right, with XUI test. And let's see. Yeah. So now my parallel test has triggered, and now you can see clone one of iPhone 11. So now I have a very minimum capacity of my memory and CPU, everything. So I can see only one clone. If capacity is high for your Mac, you can see number of clones of your simulator and you can do parallel testing. And the same thing, you can do it with your CI integration also. But you need to provide a matrix, matrix tag in your Travis.yaml, and you can provide your multiple parallel tests with the devices that you can configure with your CI integration tool. Okay, so this is pretty much that I have. Hope you have a better understanding about XUI test and when it can be used and what are the APIs. What are the waiting strategies and how you can interact with APIs with your native applications, and how you do parallel testing, how you can integrate with XUI test. Yes, so I'll go through the Q&A now. Can we use XUI test in APM or along with APM in Java? Yes, you can use, but it's especially for only for native application and native frameworks. You can also use, yes. So is changing the A11Y modifiers, so okay, as easily possible when ShiftUI is used in iOS project instead of storyboard. When you declare the accessibility modifiers, I don't think it will be modified frequently. If that is modified also, we'll be having some labels apart from your accessibility modifiers that you can find it in your storyboard as well. So APM uses WDAA, which talks to XUI APIs. Yes, APM actually using WebDriver agent to talks to XUI APIs. That's a different part, and this is a different part. So here, the XUI test will actually communicate with application using test runners instead of WebDriver agent.
And so Shobhan, I think we can take just one more question now.
My app has some APIs to validate. Is it possible to fetch data from APIs? Yeah, I already mentioned there is no provisions to talk about HTTP protocols. We soon expect the future again.
So thank you, Shobhan, for that great session.
Thank you all. Bye-bye.